live from the Melbourne studios of the National 9 Network, it's the Graham Kennedy Show. And now, here's Graham.
Yes, the issue of David's statue has reared its ugly head again. As far as porno is concerned, Mr. Maher is very meagre. Oh, that's a good line. Now, you must admit that's gold logie stuff, that one. Do you know what they call the vice squad now? The men from Mars. This is very clever material. I think my favourite one is this one. I really do. Very clever one. And also, they come in, you know, various shapes and sizes. Poor old David. What a lot of fuss about something that's been hanging around for 500 years. 500 years. He's quite an old fella, really. Of course, it's come up before over the years. It's come up before over the years. One stage, one century, or half a century, they made him wear a fig leaf. Well, the fig leaves dropped off. Well, he's still got the figs, I see there. Michael, come on. Michelangelo didn't actually start off with the intention of making David the statue. Actually, Michelangelo was making a sign for a pawn shop and he just got carried away. He searched high and low for a model, mostly low. This is my favourite. This is, I think, see, that's a sort of matte one, and this is a shiny one. There he is there. It's very good there. That's it. Now watch carefully. Yes, but I mean... I'm embarrassed about tonight, I really am. If Mr. Maher has his way, where will it all stop? I mean, Chloe, our famous Chloe, may have to have a fig leaf, and Toddy, no, Noddy. I might start again. Chloe might have to wear a fig leaf, and Noddy a tea leaf. Yes! The stir over the statue of David has been so widely publicised that Mr. Maher's office has been visited by people who are directly concerned.
Yes?
I want to see a Mr. Maher, please.
Who shall I say is calling?
Oh, my name is Dave.
David who?
Just a Dave.
Oh, excuse me, sir. There is a Mr. David wants to see you. Oh, I see. Right. I'm afraid Mr. Maher doesn't know you. Could I perhaps see your credentials?
See, yes. You look.
Oh, yes. Do you have any other means of proving that you are the David?
Oh, sure. You have this hammer.
Oh, yes. Now you can go right in.
Thanks very much.
And now, ladies and gentlemen, to open our show, coming all the way to us from New South Wales, here's Al Stein.
Daughter of darkness, stay out of my life. You took my heart, you broke it apart, you daughter of darkness. Woman, I can remember a woman. Warm were her kisses and tender was she, lying there in my arms. Why did you deceive the soul? What devil inside made you go when I needed you most of all? Daughter of darkness, stay out of my life. You took my heart, you broke it apart, you daughter of darkness. Daughter of darkness, please leave me alone forever. A daughter of is a love that we share together. Heaven, we had our own little heaven, sharing together the magic of love in a world of our own. How did you deceive us? What devil inside made you go when I needed you more?
As it had in the Age today, Al Stein. Obviously, someone from our publicity department phoned it through and said, and Al Stein's on, and they put, oh, Al dot Stein, really A-L, you see.
We knew there'd be phone calls. Thank you very much for ringing. Yes, we do realise that David was Jewish. No, well, you see, I played him as an Italian. And we had a long discussion about this afternoon. Obviously, he was Jewish. I mean, if he was Italian, his name would have been Bruno or Giuseppe. And David is a Jewish name, as in Starov. But the thing is, I can't do Jewish accent. Even after much tuition today from our director's assistant, June Brackenberg, I still can't conquer it. So we decided to be Italian. But thank you for ringing. Or at least we think. See, there's some confusion. If he was Jewish, I think you've got to buy Clio this month if I about that. But thank you for ringing. We do appreciate the calls. And as you'll notice, tonight's program is, for the first time, classified as an AO program, suitable for adults only. One of the reasons is that I've got this Colvin commercial to do, which is pretty sexy. Ask for Colvin potato chips because Colvin's got enjoyment in the bag. Gay game one. Now there's quite a party down there, believe me. Oh, that's a funny place for the Yugoslav PM to hide. Oh, look, some of the bigger chips are guarding him. They're all carrying their little potato rifles. Oh, your bloke will go insane, isn't it? Oh, there's Mr. Ma down there at the party. He's just hung his hat on a statue of David. Bless you. Hey, pass up the chips. Thank you. Oh, yes, Colvin's the light chip, the crisp chip. Oh, there's fun down there. There's plenty of enjoyment in that bag. Better late than never. Never a dull moment with a light, crisp Colvin chip. Colvin's got enjoyment in the bag, as the calf once said to his mother. It's been a long time since we did the famous... long time since we did the weights and measures test on the... Yes, we'll do that tonight. You can see how that's like, there's your bag of Colvin potato chips. That's how you buy them. Watch this. This doesn't take very long, is it? That should do it. What you really get is down there. Is that terrible? No, it's not. It's good because they're all... Ladies and gentlemen, now here's that dear old finger-licking, gherkin-farming, lemon-squeezing, squash-playing Colonel, and tonight with Vicky Hammond.
Well, I do thank you. I do thank you. I do thank you. I do thank you. Thank you. I like the boy. My friends, I'd like you all now to meet my lovely Australian cousin, Miss Vicky. You there, honey child?
I sure am.
Isn't she just too beautiful? Yeah, yeah. This is my cousin Vicky. Ain't she just too much?
Hi, Colonel Luton, sir. How are you?
Ah, just fine, just fine. Not only beautiful is this girl, friends, but she has a very important point to make about my Kentucky Fried Chicken.
Well, I sure do, because in these days of very high food prices, I think your Kentucky Fried Chicken is fantastic value.
Oh, hallelujah.
And not only that, you have designed a pack to suit everybody.
True, Miss Vicky, true.
It sure is. Now, for instance, for a lunch just for one person, here's your little lunch bag. Yeah. And in it, you get a delicious piece of Kentucky Fried Chicken and chips for only 45 cents. Now, that is fantastic.
Hallelujah, hallelujah.
Sure is. And also, all these other packs right up to the big barrel here. And in that, you get 21 pieces of chicken.
Hallelujah.
Enough for a big family or even a party for only $5.20. You're super.
Finger-licking chicken in a size surprise to suit everybody.
Sure is.
Yeah.
In short, Colonel, Kentucky Fried Chicken is fantastic value.
That's right, Miss Vicky, and that's the way it'll stay just as long as there's breath left in my body.
Hang in there, Kurt. We're nearly finished. Now, come on, you hold it.
Yeah, right. It's fantastic value. And don't forget, folks, honey child, it's
so finger-licking good.
I like the girl. I like her.
Oh, Colonel Sanders there and the lovely Vicky Hammond returning to television.
It takes time to brew a good beer. In fact, the longer you take, the better the beer. That's why we slow brew Tankard Bitter. Brew it longer than any other bitter in Victoria. Tankard Bitter gets smoother and clearer, while the flavor gets bigger and bigger. Slow brewed Tankard Bitter costs a cent extra. What a difference a cent makes.
Oh, yes. I had my picture taken with our next guest, Evie Pickler, earlier in the week, and we had to we had to pose very close together, and it was a very pleasant sensation indeed. It really was. I want you to know that. One Duke was pushing right into me, Warwick, and it was divine. So, let's find out now whether Evie Pickler can sing. Oh, of course she can sing, because she was in the Sydney production of Jesus Christ Superstar. In fact, one could say, and I've heard her sing, and I've seen her, and I've been with her, you could say Evie Pickler is a bottler. Here's Evie Pickler. Come on.
You just called out my name, and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you again. When you're down and troubled, you got a friend when people can be so cold. They'll hurt you and they'll desert you and take your soul if you let them. Oh, don't you let them. You just call out my name and you know wherever I am, I'll come running to see you. Winter, spring, summer, or fall, all you got to do is call, and I'll be there, yes I will. You got a friend, yes you got a friend. Ain't it good to know, ain't it good to know.
Oh, isn't she absolutely beautiful? This is Evie Pickler up close with me. We had it, didn't we have our picture taken?
Yes, we did.
And wasn't it good?
Oh, it was so good.
She laughs a lot too.
Yes, auntie, I'm very happy.
Why aren't you in the Melbourne Jesus Christ Superstar?
Well, I had to go overseas.
Oh, when?
I had to sing for the US troops.
Oh, did you in...
Yes, and that's why I left Superstar.
Oh, in Vietnam?
Well, all over the East.
Oh.
Yes.
Well, it's lovely to have you with us.
Oh, it's lovely to be here.
Will you come back again?
I'd love to, Graham.
We have our picture really? Taken again. We won't sing or anything. We'll just have the pictures taken in the dressing room. I like that part best of all. Oh, what do you think of all this fuss over a classic statue?
Yes.
What do you mean, oh, yes?
David. That is David, isn't it?
That's David, yes. But, I mean, it's a statue that we've all seen 1,000 times.
Oh, yes.
It doesn't worry you, does it?
Worry me? Why, no, not indeed.
Oh, well.
Good. I rather enjoy it, actually.
Good on you.
Oh, I'd love to.
Good night.
Bye.
Right. Evie Pickler.
Oh, when it's time to feed your puppy dog, here's what you should do. Go for Bif Health Formula, the balanced food. Your doggy will love it, true. Yeah, and it's available for pussycats too. Oh, yeah.
Oh, that's a tremendous song. That song is so far up the doggy pole that even a Great Dane couldn't reach it. Yes, it's Bif time. Bif, king of pet foods, with the built-in health formula. Look, see, here, the formula is on the label. Many dog owners throw the stuff inside away and just give the dog the label to eat. Bif Gold Can keeps your dog actively healthy. Does it ever? About 36 trees to the gallon. Because of its balanced diet. Bif is full of premium quality, rich red meat and vegetables with added vitamins and minerals. Reach for Bif, the best pet food money can buy. Brian, could we do it slowly, like with feeling? Like a sexy one. Very, very slow. Yeah.
When it's time to feed your puppy dog, here's what you should do. Go for Bif Health Formula, the balanced food. Yet doggy will love it true. It's available for pussycats too.
Yeah. Oh, right down here in the David.
Would you like to hear it louder? Would you like to hear it longer? Would you like to hear it clearer? Would you like to hear it stronger? Ever ready, ready? To pull the music in.
A large portion of the roasts we buy for our families, we feed to our ovens. But GLAD scientists have come up with a very simple answer. The GLAD oven bag, a heat-resistant, see-through bag that keeps all the natural flavor and juices right where they belong. You end up with the most succulent roast you've ever tasted, and a clean oven. Imagine a really tender, juicy roast that leaves the oven clean. It's in the bag. The GLAD oven bag.
I guess you've noticed that almost every TV news service ends with a story of a likely humorous nature. But occasionally, because of lack of time, these have to be dropped. Well, now, we think you should see them. And so we've collected a number of news stories that were never shown on television. Highland Games are currently being held all over Scotland. Did you know that? I didn't know that until today. Highland Games are currently being held all over Scotland, but some of the Braw Luddies and their Lassies have their own favourite games. enough. You could have heard a pin drop. Yes, in Chicago today, here's a serious one. In Chicago today, a young man threatened suicide as he stood on the ledge of a skyscraper 47 stories above the street.
Don't jump, my son. Oh. Don't jump. You're so young. You have so much to live for.
No, I can't stand it, Father. You can't talk me out about it. I'm going to jump. You see, I'm different to other men, and that's why I can't stand being different. It's because I'm different that I'm going to jump.
No, don't jump, my son. Don't jump.
I will. I'm going to jump 47 stories and fall to my death. Ah! Oh, I'm different from other men.
Isn't it? Not funny, but very technically clever. Ladies and gentlemen, Geraldine Doyle is here with guitar and Mountain Dew.
Let grasses grow and waters flow in a free and easy way. But give me a drop of the rare old stuff that's brewed near Galway Bay. Come peelers all from Donegal, Sligo and Leitrim too. We'll give them the slip and we'll take a sip of the rare old Mountain Dew. I diddly oot and I can dum diddly oot and I can dum diddly oot, die three I day. Diddly oot and I can dum diddly oot and I can dum diddly oot, die three I day. Oh, at the foot of the hill there's a neat little still with the smoke curls up in the sky. By the smoke and the smell you can plainly tell there's what she'll do nearby.
Geraldine Doyle and Mountain Dew. Beaut words. Diddly idly um dum diddly idly do do. Hello, Rosemary Margin. She's wearing a Rosemary Margin fashion.
Yes.
Too. And looking very pretty. What a clever girl you are. Designer, weather forecaster.
Not quite. I'm
hairdresser. Stale weather. Yes. Stale weather it is too. It's recorded weather. That weather that you get on the Channel 9 News is not fresh.
It is fresh.
It's pre-recorded weather.
It's fresh weather.
It's fresher than Channel 2's. Channel 2's keep saying at 3 o'clock this afternoon. Who cares what it was like at 3 o'clock?
At least we have a 5:15 report.
At least, yes, yes, at least. You know, Rosemary, if you're... I want to talk to the people just for a second.
Oh, yes.
If your hair is difficult to manage, choose Seedle Hard to Hold. They've got a special spray which is called... That's
pink
not it.
One.
It's the pink one. It's called Hard to Hold. That's that one.
Yes. And if your hair is easy to manage, then you need Seedle's Regular. That's the green one.
That's that one.
Yes, all right. I bought a pink one too because I use that all the time.
She
anyway,
uses that all the time.
Seedle Hairspray will turn your quick set into a day-long delight.
Oh.
Keeping your hair perfectly controlled and soft and shiny.
Yes.
In fact, I do use it every day and I really find it is very wonderful.
I believe you. And Seedle Men's Hairdressing is rather superb. It keeps a man's hair looking dry, natural, and always in place, just as if you'd put cement on it. I heard of a bloke once who held his hair in place, just he tried it once, with cement. He went straight out and cracked it. This is true. It's a true thing.
I'm off to see that we're all being a little bit more friendly. T-A-A. It's just that little bit more so thoroughly friendly. That little bit of extra that you get from TAA. Says TAA for that little bit of extra friendliness. And we can tell you that at TAA, we want to be just a little more friendly. Just a little bit
just a little bit, just a little friendliness. Goes a long, long way when you come to fly with TAA. So come and join us now at TAA. You'll come to understand we fly the friendly way. So come on now and settle back with TAA. Fly TAA.
When it comes to chicken, folks, the Colonel cooks it up a treat. Ain't nobody cooks chicken like the Colonel, because nobody else knows the Colonel's secret recipe of 11 different herbs and spices. Kentucky Fried Chicken. It's finger-lickin' good.
The Peter Smith Show Biz Special. What?
Yes, but we didn't arrange to have that on the
that
table.
That doesn't offend you, surely. It's a statue of David by Michelangelo. Or well, some people say Michelangelo.
Well, I'm sorry, but it does offend me.
Oh, goodness. Oh, all right. Sorry. Well, look, I can fix that because I thought this might happen and I had wardrobe make a little thing.
Well, I can still see.
Now, is that better? Now, I think that's infinitely more obscene.
Oh, no, not at all. No, he's on his way to Olympic Park or somewhere.
Well, I'm, you know, I'm an athletic supporter.
Oh, Pete, you got your purple velvet on.
You've noticed.
Jeez.
Beautiful, isn't it?
Yes.
Ready for 1975, isn't if we ever nice. Make it. Do you realise what we have for you? Do you realise what we have for you tonight?
More scenes from Last Tango in Paris.
I have them upstairs, but unfortunately they cannot be shown.
Where he talks to his dead wife. Let's have that one.
Oh, that's there's too much coffin in that one. Well,
what about the part with the where they have a picnic and there's the butter? Yeah. Let's have that part.
What? There's no picnic in it.
Oh, I think they were having a picnic.
I'm sorry, that must have been the bit that I went up to change the spools or something. Because Peter, I was running it back to...
I noticed during the running of Last Tango in Paris, you left the theatre alone.
I did. I was in charge of the spools. I told you that.
While we were watching you having spooling.
They never left my hands. The spools had to be in my charge all the time. I didn't like to, you know, put it onto you. You were there to enjoy yourself. But I had to have the responsibility. Eagerly awaited tonight is the Australian production, and this is our spot tonight... The Australian production of Jesus Christ Superstar.
Oh, is that tonight?
Yeah, we have it tonight.
Oh, I can talk about that until the cows come home.
There are very few people who are as close to the Australian production as yourself.
Well, no, not really. I've seen it once.
Well, as far as interest is concerned, certainly.
I do have an interest. Oh, yeah, well, I have a financial...
I don't mean a financial
Oh, you didn't
interest.
Mean that. What did you mean?
I meant an interest in the show.
Oh, yes, of course I have an interest in the
have
show.
Have you an interest in the show as well?
Oh, yes, and already two checks have been in and excellent.
Yes.
Well, and a couple of Poles and three Italians.
May I tell you, it's beautiful, and we love promoting Australian talent, do we not?
Of course we do.
This is the Australian cast album of the show, the Harry Miller production, and this is already a gold album. That means it's sold over... $50,000 worth.
I must say, you know, all congratulations to the way Australian recordings are now not only being recorded, and the like the Ted Hamilton album is superb, but also the covers and the colour photography really is
fantastic.
Excellent.
The staging in that is incredible, isn't it? Can you tell us just a very tiny bit about the staging, because it is magnificent, isn't it?
Well, at the Capitol Theatre, I think one of the beaut things is that Harry's putting it on at the Palais in Melbourne. Was to go to the Metro, and we all got a bit nervous because they would have to lower the stage, take the proscenium. Too much.
But it's a legitimate theatre, the Metro Collins Street, Metro Burb.
Well, of course it's a legitimate. I didn't say it wasn't a legitimate theatre.
Well, why do they have to pull the stage up?
Oh, well, it would be too small to mount this enormous show. Yeah. And it looked lovely. It looked regal at the Capitol in Sydney. It's going to look even better at the Palais because that's even larger.
Takes me back, you know, I was on the stage there.
At the Palais?
The Children's Cinema Club.
Were you really?
Oh, yes, in the comic swap shop in the foyer. Don't you remember those days?
Well, I remember Harry Jacobs in the orchestra and sitting in the back row of the front stalls for a shilling and seeing two films, news and a stage presentation.
Hell Machete?
Oh, no, it's just a bit close in here, that's all.
I meant Hal Machete, the band.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Oh, no, he didn't appear at the Palais, did he? He was at the TIV.
He worked all over the place, the late Mr. Machete. What are we doing tonight?
We're not bringing the entire cast of 40 in. We're not bringing the 39 musicians.
Are we bringing the dodecahedron in? Because that's interesting. That cost $96,000, that thing.
No, I don't think we're doing that because of the complexities in lugging it around, so to speak.
I see.
But what we do have for you is a tremendous performance by the young gentleman who plays Judas Iscariot.
John English.
John English
is
on the show tonight.
Ah!
We have secured his services.
Good heavens, how do we do that?
He's also going to sing.
Really?
Mm. He's going to do one of the big hit numbers from the show, which is Heaven on Their Minds.
John English, ladies and gentlemen.
My mind is clearer now. At last, all too well, I can see where we all soon will be. If you strip away the myth from the man, you will see where we all soon will be. Jesus, you have started to believe the things they said of you. You really do believe this talk of God is true. And all the good you've done will soon get swept away. You've begun to matter more than the things. Like what I see, all I ask is that you listen to me. And remember, I've been your right-hand man all along. You have set them all on fire. They found the new Messiah, and they'll hurt you when they find the law. Look, I remember when this whole thing began. Some other way. Oh, and they'll hurt you when they think you lied. Now's a rip, your famous son should have stayed a great unknown, like his father Carmen. Would he'd have made good table jazz and open chest, would have suited Jesus best. He'd have caused nobody harm. No one alarm. Listen, Jesus, do you care for your race? Can't you see we must keep in our place? We are occupied. Crush us if we go too far. If we go too far. Listen. Listen, Jesus, to the warning I give. Please remember that I want us to live. Let us go sad to see our chances. Beautiful, but now it's sour. Yes, it's all.
Say hello, John. This is Peter Smith, John English.
Hello, Johnny. How are you? Nice to meet you. Graham Kennedy.
Hello, nice to see you. How long have you been with the season for the full-time job?
A whole lot, yeah.
Never missed a performance?
One or two, you know.
No.
How's the voice standing up?
Oh, pretty well. You know, I've had 2 weeks off and been larking about and one thing like that.
I'm trying to get the message across before how beautiful the show will probably look at the Palais, probably better than the Capitol.
It's got to be done in a big theatre, and the bigger the theatre, the better. We did it at Adelaide Festival of Arts with 10,000, just a concert, and that looked good. So, come along to the Palais, eh?
Of course, we're not allowed about that. Flocking along. And thank you for being on our show,
John. Thank you, Graham.
Good on you, John. Thank you, sir. Thank you, Peter. So many people have asked me, immediately after the performance, I've heard that you're going to Luna Park. Is this true? After the opening night performance?
Oh, well, yes, for a waffle.
Just a waffle?
Well, I can't ever pass Luna Park without getting a waffle.
I don't think they have waffles there anymore.
Yes, and you can have your picture taken sitting on the moon.
No, that's gone too.
That's gone too. Mm. Shows you how long it is since I've been.
You're going there, though.
River Cave's still there. I feel safe on the River Cave. I don't like the Big Dipper. I get sick. On the River Cave, it's all right.
Well, can we meet somewhere at Luna Park after the show?
If you want to, in the River Cave.
Oh, no, I didn't mean it that way. I meant I thought we could discuss a few show business.
All right, well, I'll see you in the House of Horrors or the Octopus.
Listen, you wouldn't believe what I've got for you next week.
What have you got?
I won't tell you.
Surprise?
Yeah, surprise for next week, but something that we've never had before.
Oh, blissy tits.
Okay?
Yes. All right, Pete, well, I'll say goodnight to you now.
Good night.
Good night, Peter.
Graham Kennedy Show.
Trent, age 41, architect. Ted is running for his life. Regular exercise and a sensible approach to diet is Ted's way of prolonging it. Kellogg's Special K has the essential protein his body needs and uses up fast. Fruit juice, black coffee, and Kellogg's Special K, the delicious high-protein Weight Watchers breakfast that picks you up, doesn't weigh you down.
I knew I left something out. We have some interesting facts here about Jesus Christ Superstar. Only one thing I wanted to say. You may have read it in the paper. I did. In the last week of the Sydney run, the production did 10 performances, that's at the Capitol, between Monday and Saturday, and audiences were in excess of 21,000, with box office takings of $110,000. That's some kind of record, I believe. For that theatre in Sydney. Ladies and gentlemen, R.C. Cola, you all know about R.C. Cola, and to present their message tonight, one of the second most famous R.C. of them all, Bert Newton.
Thank you, Graham. Here before your very eyes, we have one large litre bottle of R.C. Cola. R.C., the cola, we call the people mixer. Now, there's a very good reason for that. First of all, the flavour. It's unique among colas. You'd have to sample quite a few colas before you'd find one that tasted as fresh and tasted as sparkling, as effervescent as R.C. It bursts with bubbles. It's got a really fresh feeling every time you taste the people mixer. That's what we call it. Take a little bottle of R.C. Cola along to a party or to a friend's place and just get together. Some ice. Pardon fingers. Whack some in. Look at that. Bubbles as fresh as the month of May. Look. Bubbling everywhere. R.C.
This is going to be a shock to the old General's mutts.
R.C. will go as quickly as you'd want it to at a party. It won't go as quickly as you want it to at a party. It'll go very quickly. That's what I'm trying to say. So make sure you get a litre bottle of R.C. R.C. the people mixer. It's fresh. It's bubble. Here's looking up your best aunt.
Here's looking up your best aunt.
It's an old saying.
I don't believe tonight's show anyway. I don't think it's really happening. Oh, listen, I've discovered a story that's a bit spicy. Do you want me to read some of it?
Yeah.
Really? Very spicy. I'll read it. Listen to this. Prime beef. Tomato puree. Carrots. I'd show you a picture of all these, but, you know, after the thing about David, we hesitate to show pictures of vegetables. Onions. Red bell peppers. We have a recording here of a red bell pepper. Thank you. Celery. And wait for it, special spices. Yes, see, it wasn't in the book at all. I was really reading the ingredients from this can of Tom Piper casserole dinner. One of these delicious braised dinners by Tom Piper. There's bistro dinner and braised dinner too. You see, you can't judge a book by its cover. Ho, ho, Noel Paton. Have a... Yes, beat the meat rise. Have a cold shower. Read a few cans of Tom Piper Praise Dinners when you're in the supermarket, and then try it at home. Believe me, Tom Piper casserole dinners taste uncanny. Oh, there's another side split. Tom Piper, Tom Piper, Tom P-I-P-E-R. You'll save on meat, just eat your feet, Tom P-I-P-E-R. Tom P-I-P-E-R. Yes. It's very hot. Do you think the air conditioning's working? Is Mr. Fisher blowing through the keyhole? Oh, a wonderful thing happened. Did I tell you what happened today? Ladies and gentlemen, you won't believe this, but I went round to the front office. I'm pretty nervous about going around there at the best of times because you've got to pass the cans in, which is wonderful here in Melbourne. And I went round and I had a simple request. Well, you know, it's not so simple anymore. There was a time when we didn't worry too much about expense, but now I remember the old days when you could get a copy of the Herald delivered to your door on the nights you worked, and I went around and I got it. I filled in four forms, and I don't have to put in either. They actually bring it, and I don't have to pay for it. Isn't that tremendous? A copy each Tuesday and Thursday of the final Herald. No, I was so thrilled, because that's, well, that adds up, doesn't it? No, over, you know, over 9 months, that's a couple of dollars. You know, for that, you could buy an audio apprentice. thank you. Keep those calls coming in. Yes, we know the whole thing, the whole show tonight is quite distasteful. I'm the first to agree. Booksellers, of course, are certainly having a tough time. It's very difficult for a bookseller because, you know, he's not sure what to buy in case he stocks it and then he gets pinched for it. Mind you, of course, I believe some booksellers should get into trouble. Some of those paperbacks have very misleading covers. I bought one recently and it showed on the cover a naked blonde about to be raped by a bloke in a leather jacket. And when I got it home, it turned out to be a motorcycle manual. And it's not only the police who are confiscating alleged porno material. There are also several self-elected vigilante groups.
Obscene photographs.
Yes. How many do you want? Here's John Lidgerwood to delight you with some music from Lerner and Lowe. Here's John. John Lidgerwood it was, with some songs from Camelot. Ah! Here's my Foster's. I've been waiting for this commercial all night. It's a beard commercial, because you get to have a little sip of a rather superb product. Oh, look at that. Oh, yes. What famous book does this remind you of? That's right. Forever Amber. Oh, dear. That hits the spot faster than a bomb in Canberra. No surprises there. You always know with Foster's that superb Foster's taste, crisp and mellow and refreshing. No wonder it's been my favourite beer for many, many years, and it's been yours. It's been Victoria's favourite beer for 80 years. Foster's Lager. Shouldn't every lager taste this good? Cheers, Foster's.
What does the Australian motorist want most from his service station? This question was asked in a recent Australia-wide survey by Morgan Research, and 81% of all motorists came through with one straightforward answer. They want expert, reliable mechanical service. Let's take a look at the results. 81% of motorists want better mechanics, men with know-how and ability. 42% of the same motorists feel accurate electronic fault-finding equipment is a necessity. And a further 35% believe service stations can be made to look better, as well as operate more efficiently. One oil company, Esso, has decided to adopt these findings. Accordingly, Esso is rebuilding and re-equipping its service stations. You can be the judge of the results.
Everything is beautiful.
everything is beautiful with Western Star Butter, the purest, freshest, most flavoursome butter of all.
I'll sing it, children.
Everybody's beautiful.
Everybody's beautiful.
To make someone you love beautiful, trust Western Star Butter, the natural best.
And now it's time for Graham's Wheel, starring Bert Newton.
Tonight, a lucky contestant could win a return trip for two to anywhere in Australia plus $200 spending money. And also, you'll have the chance to win the Safe Start to Happy Motoring with this prize of five Dunlop tyres. Or you'll have the chance of winning this truly great stereo console stereogram from Chrysler. Both these prizes come to you from Walton's.
Graham, this is Mrs. Norris from North Croydon. Mrs. Norris.
Hello, Mrs. Norris. Nice to have you with us on our program. We've introduced this new prize where if you choose a number and it stops on that number, you win a trip anywhere in Australia with $200 spending money, which is not a bad prize.
Very nice.
You can choose a number between 1 and 28, Mrs. Norris.
14.
14.
There it is.
There we are. Oh, whatever happens, you're in for a thrill there.
Right here, Mrs. Norris.
That's it.
Number four. For you, Mrs. Well. Norris. And prize number four is a pair of famous blue Levi jeans. Teamed with a glow-weave body shirt of your choice, and the value is $22 from Walton's.
Do you have a family, Mrs. Norris?
Yes, well, that'll do Gregory very well.
Gregory?
Yeah.
Is he home watching?
I hope so.
Well,
should be.
Mum's going to... Is he? What's he got?
Oh, just a...
Oh, has he? No, but I mean, you might be a carrier, and you haven't told me. Here's your question. It's easy to. What was the name of the artist responsible for the famous work of art referred to simply as David?
Oh, Michelangelo.
Michelangelo is right. Quite correct, and thank you for being on our program. I hope Gregory gets well soon.
Also on Graham's Wheel tonight, you'll have the chance of winning this magnificent 12.5 cubic feet two-door refrigerator by Kelvinator, or this handy Philips 20-inch portable TV for truly portable TV viewing. Both these prizes come to you from Walton's.
Oh, I've done a terrible thing.
What's wrong?
Kirby? Well, in pulling off the pressure-sensitive sticker, I've also hurt Sunbeam there.
What a pity.
Oh, yeah, never mind.
Yes, yes. Glad you didn't do it.
We've lost Sunbeam there.
Mrs. Duke Chapman, Graham.
Oh, hang on.
What's wrong?
Oh, well, I've got that there.
Well, throw one up.
Well, I'm trying to, and it won't... No, not that's the good one. That's the one. Thank you.
No, I've got them.
Well, I'll... There we are.
This is Mrs. Judith Chapman, Graham, from Mulgrave.
Hello.
Hello.
Mrs. Chapman.
She's a very young Mrs., isn't she?
You're a very young Mrs. Chapman.
Don't you think so?
Judith, we have something which is very interesting. A telegram arrived for you today.
Oh, did it?
And it fell on the floor.
Oh.
Where is it? Oh, pardon me.
Goodness me.
Which is unusual, isn't it? It's a good wish thing. Yeah. I had to open the
Should I all read it? Yeah. I can't stand it if it's...
It reads, John and Judy Chapman, care of Graham Kennedy's Wheel with Bert Newton, 22 Bendigo Street, Richmond, Vic.
Doesn't say with Bert Newton, just as Graham...
I did, though.
Lots of good luck with the wheel tonight from all your friends.
Yes, in Melbourne.
Oh, isn't
that
nice?
That's lovely, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah.
Keep that.
I don't
Any
know...
children, Mrs. Chapman?
Yes, little girl, 20 months.
Ah, lovely.
I came from a family that wouldn't open telegrams. We
oh, bad news, I think. Yes.
Yeah, no, it didn't matter what was in it. Oh, no, that's
you
good.
You can
live in there. Oh, righto, I'll stick at me kick. no, but we wouldn't. We'd sit there and look at it all day on the mantelpiece and go, oh, I bet that's bad news. And, you know, you'd never know until... Where would you like me to... what number do you choose between 1 and 20?
Number six.
Oh.
It's a man's cardigan.
It's a man's cardigan in any case. Right.
Around here, Judith.
And for heaven's sake, let it go, because if you don't, you know, and it's not...
That was the force of current from the air conditioning.
Oh, was it? Have another spin, Bert's correct.
Yes, that's...
Number three.
Number
3 for you, Judith.
And do you know, I actually, without intending to, I did help a bit because I leant too close and it slowed down because I hooked in my coat.
Hmm. But no correspondence will be entered into.
No, our judge's decision is completely final.
This is a lovely one. Do you have a home?
Yes.
Of your own? Well, this will go in beautifully. You have a lounge room?
Yes.
You've got a lounge suite there?
Yes.
Well, you've got two now.
That's great.
Laverna, three-piece lounge suite. It's a welcome addition to any home. It's made of the finest material, and by skilled craftsmen, Waltons have great pleasure in giving you the chance of winning this prize. Isn't it beautiful?
Is the one you've got now as lovely as that?
No, it's not.
Oh, well, good. Flog that. Give that to the mother-in-law and keep the goodie. That's if you win it. Oh, question's easy. You'll have no problem. What is the name of the river? Oh, I remember asking this question some years ago. What is the name of the river? And I got a very funny answer. What is the name of the river dividing Victoria from New South Wales? I asked this once before, and
you
I got
the error.
From a very nervous contestant. She wasn't really responsible for what she was so petrified. And I asked that question. She said Africa. Way, way back, 1961, perhaps.
The Murray is
That's correct. It. Congratulations. Thank you very much.
There's your telegram.
Oh, yes.
There you are. I think there's another little chap on the way. If you'd like to be on Graham's Wheel, all you have to do is write to these addresses. This address. Graham's Wheel, Post Office Box 333, Richmond 3121. Also, entry forms and boxes are available at all Walton stores. And don't forget the address. If you want to send in, it's Graham's Wheel, Post Office Box 333, Richmond, Victoria 3121.